Now, let me ask this, switch gears, and let's talk about the Austrian death machine, because this is kind of something I think that might have become something you did as a side project just to kill some time, and it's kind of becoming popular, isn't it?
Yes, it's pretty funny, you know, how it really kind of picked up, and I think that, you know, part of the appeal is just that, you know, metal is such a serious genre all the time. It's kind of nice to have something a little more lighthearted, but still, you know, musically intense.
Right. So, I guess, tell us how that came. How did that even come to be?
It is kind of, you know, like I was saying, just a more of a lighthearted outlet. You know, something that was fun, and I picked. You know, I couldn't really picture a better theme for a unique voice or a, you know, memorable, you know, classic quote than you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Seems like, you know, even people that haven't seen his movies hear enough other people doing impersonations that they know his lines, you know, so.
Sure.
Seemed like it already had a little bit of a foundation, you know, with every listener, and I thought it would be really fun.
Well, it's kind of a comical theme in a way, but it's also one that it fits, doesn't it? It just, you know, the music's great, and I mean, who does, you hear those, you know, like Get to the Chopper, who hasn't seen that movie? And that scene, and so, you know, it works. I don't know, it just, it fits, doesn't it? Now, I seen on there where it says that you play all the instruments.
Yeah, that's kind of the whole other idea too, is just to be able to write songs, you know, by myself, and you know, just kind of do whatever I feel like. I think sometimes to me, it just makes the songwriting process, you know, a lot less stressful, and, you know, just, you know, nobody else like have to worry about teaching parts or anything like that. Just kind of writing whatever I feel like.
Sure. Now, is this something that you recorded in your studio?
Yeah, we did that in my studio, which is kind of nice too. We didn't have to put other projects on hold. We just kind of filled in the gaps of when we're recording other bands. We had a few studios here, a few studios there, and next thing we knew, we were all done with the record.
Sure. Now, would you have had the opportunity to ever have done this and actually record it if you had to have, like, buy studio time?
That's a good question. You know, I think I probably still would have done it, yeah. You know, I definitely still would have done it. I just probably would not have been able to be as much of a perfectionist as I like to be, you know, because that stuff gets pretty expensive after a while.
Would like Metal Blades have been willing to put the money behind it if they had to use a studio, though? It seems to me like you got a great advantage by having invested in a studio in your own home.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that enabled me to do, you know, Austrian Death Machine. But I know Metal Blades is really excited about it, but they probably wouldn't have had a chance to hear it in the first place. It's not one of those things where you can really explain to somebody until you have to finish product something to show them, you know. So.
Right. Yeah.
That's how the whole thing worked out with Metal Blades.
Now, when I heard that you played all the instruments on it, I could believe that you did, of course, the singing and the guitar playing and stuff like that. But the drumming, now, when I first heard that, I thought, oh, no, surely not. Surely that doesn't really mean he played the drums, because it's phenomenal drum work. That's actually you playing the drums.
Well, the beauty of modern recordings is, you know, how you can combine, you know, especially with anything rhythmic, you know, a lot mm-hmm. of programming mixed with, you know, with real drumming, and I think that's
sure.
You know, I mean, even you know, I've even seen great, great drummers, you know, who when they're in the studio, just when it comes to, you know, kick drum and snare drum, they use a lot of samples and stuff like that. So I've learned all those tricks kind of over time, and you know, for that record, the key to getting it to sound that way is just combining, you know, all the real elements and things, you know, like the cymbals and all that stuff that that can't be programmed, and combining those with you know, the double bass, you know, trickery that I've learned over the years.
Sure. So it's simulated. It's not necessarily you getting behind the kit and being like one of the most phenomenal drummers I've ever heard.
No, definitely not the entire kit. That's for sure.
That's the miracle of modern recording, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, the fun part is all the stuff that I put together in the studio and you know, like. Seeing some really amazing drummers pull that stuff off live, you know, like that.
Sure.
You know, we do Austrian Death Machine shows, and the drummer from Software Cowboy, he plays drums for me, and he does an amazing job live. So, you know, somebody somebody can play all those things without 200 studio takes like I did, you know?
Sure. Someone who spent their life getting that good, I suppose.
Yeah.
Now, you've put a band together because you're going to be playing some live shows. Who's in your band?
Well, like I was just mentioned, the drummer, his name's John Rice from Job for a Cowboy, is playing drums, and a friend of mine who did guitar solos on the album, his name is Mark McDonald, and he did a few of the solos, you know, on the record, and he plays the lead guitar stuff when we do live shows, and Josh, the bass player from As We're Dying, plays bass, and then the rhythm guitar player sort of changes occasionally depending on who's available, you know, because it's not a full-time band, but the majority of the shows have been my friend JP, who plays in a funk band called Death by Stereo.
And how about, has Arnold Schwarzenegger ever commented himself on this? Surely this has caught his ear.
I mean, I've heard rumors, you know, that he has heard it. I'll never know if they're true unless he makes some sort of official statement, I guess. I don't know if it'll be a good or bad thing if he finds out, because, you know, I don't know if he'd be... I, of course, don't want him to be offended, but you never know how somebody might take something.
Sure. So you haven't had to get his permission to use his voice. Some of your shirts have his image on it.
Well, that's one of the reasons, you know, I figure, well, you know, I don't know if it's a good or bad thing if he finds out. So we'll see, I guess, when the time comes.
So you may have some answering to do to the governor, huh?
Maybe. Possibility, that's for sure.
Hey, it's just good promotion for him. I mean, not only that, I could see him pairing up with you and doing the voiceovers himself. Now, that'd be really cool, wouldn't it?
That would be amazing. Yeah, absolutely.